Yeah. A minute. I'll go ahead and
okay.
Thank you, Jeff. I'm very happy to be here today, and I appreciate you giving me your time and attention. I'd like to tell you a little bit about the Community Connect program today, and I'd like to talk specifically about our summer program, which is coming up, but I'd also like to get some feedback and input from you and answer any questions you might have about our program. I'd like to start off just by asking you to tell me with a show of hands, how many of you have heard of Community Connect before Jeff mentioned in my introduction? Okay, so we have a newbie here. Good, awesome. But I'm really excited that most of you have heard. I still run into people sometimes, and when I tell them what I do, they're like, Community Connect, what's that? And then I tell them, they're like, oh, yeah, yeah, I've heard of that. So I'm excited that everyone here has heard of our program. How many of you think that you could explain to that one or two people out there who don't know what Community Connect is, what it is? Okay, anybody want to take a stab at summarizing briefly what our program is? All right, I'm going to pick up anybody. Community Connect is a community education and enrichment program for Dalham and Hartley counties. We offer classes for adults and for kids. We offer it during four sessions. We have a fall session, a winter session, spring, and summer. And I'm going to tell you about summer. That's our biggest and busiest session. But we just ended our spring session yesterday. Since October, we have had piano classes running for 5- and 6-year-olds and another class running for 7- to 10-year-olds. I think that's a really great example of what Community Connect does. We have Candy Badiger, who offers private lessons. She works up at the library at the junior high. And so she offers really affordable group piano lessons using the piano lab that WT donated to Community Connect, which is housed at the junior high. And so we just are able to bring together all these resources in the community so that our kids can get exposure to music and piano lessons at a very affordable price.
That's funny because that's exactly what I was going to say.
I bet it was.
Word for word. That's exactly how it was.
And so we had a variety of classes this past spring. So the recital for the piano classes was yesterday. On the 26th, we had Learn to Fish. The local game warden, Stuart Rogers, brought in some of his colleagues, and they taught 9 of our local kids how to fish. All the kids that day caught a fish, so they're ready for the fishing derby that's going to be this Saturday. We had a couple weekends ago, my husband and I both participated in Dutch oven campfire cooking with Peter Balmer, which was an awesome class, and we got to have a delicious feast at the end of the class. And so we really just try to listen to the community, what they're interested in, find people to teach it. You know, it was in one of my advisory council meetings that somebody said, I'd really like to learn how to do that Dutch oven campfire cooking. And one of my other members says, my husband does that. I'll tell him he has to teach a class. And so, you know, just bringing people together to do that. Yes, I'm very happy about that. He did a great job. We had a lot of fun. And so we're always looking for input and ideas. If you enjoy teaching, please, I'm going to show you our website in a moment, but you can contact us over the website. My office is at the DISD Administration Building on 10th Street. You can stop in anytime. We're always looking for new ideas and teachers to help us out. One of the really unique things about Community Connect that I think is important to point out is how we're funded. The majority of community education programs are usually part of the public school system or an extension of the public school system. And so what has happened is public school funding has been cut. A lot of the community education programs in those communities have been one of the first things to go. But Community Connect is funded by 5 separate entities. We're funded by Dalham County, Hartley County, the city of Dalhart, Dalhart ISD, and the Dalham-Hartley County Hospital District. And so that financial burden of the program is distributed, and that gives us a lot of flexibility and freedom and independence that a lot of other community education programs don't have, and which really, it really is very unique about our program that we have that kind of support from the community and that those separate entities really recognize and support and value the program that we have. And some community education programs are also run through local colleges and universities. And when Frank Phillips College came last year, I heard a lot of people say, well, are they taking over Community Connect? Are you guys going to become part of them? And maybe in the future they might combine, but right now there are no plans for that. And I've talked to Lou Honeycutt, who's the vice president over there, a couple different occasions, and he said, you know, I don't think people realize what a gem Community Connect is and how unique that is for a community, that it's so supported by all these different entities. And to be honest, certainly if people want to, we could join at some point in time. He said, but why would we? He said, you know, as a college, we have a lot of rules and regulations that restrict the classes that we can do. You have to have a minimum number, when you can offer it. He said, you don't have any of that. And so that really is one of the things I love about our program, that we can listen to what the community needs, and we can try to fill the gaps when there are. You know, in addition to the classes that we offer for adults and for kids, we also do we do community events. We organize, together with Texas Parks and Wildlife, the community cleanup that we just had on April 5th, where we had almost 400 volunteers come up and help clean out the lake and the surrounding areas. We coupled and partnered together with Girl Scouts, and we did an anti-bullying program with them this past year. Sylvie, in the past, has done a financial literacy program. I've been attending the Strategic Planning Committee meetings with Dalhart ISD, and it looks like we have a need for an after-school program, so we're going to try to get that started. And so it's not just the classes that we offer. We really do try to see how can we improve the quality of life here in Dalhart. What does the community need, and then try to move in and fill those needs. So what I'd like to talk about next is our summer program. As I said, that is our biggest and busiest session that we have. This catalog is at the printer right now, so I don't have one for everybody. But they will be going home with the kids next week, so keep your eye out for backpacks. And if you don't have a child that's in kindergarten through fifth grade right now, I'll have some at my office. You're welcome to pick them up if you have grandkids who might be visiting for the summer. We've got a lot of really, really great programs coming up. And I'd like to get a little Excel sheet so that everyone can kind of see what the schedule is. Now, I don't think I have enough for everybody. If you could maybe share.
Okay, some of us can't read, so.
Yeah, okay. Well, I have some pretty pictures.
Yeah, do you have a reading program or something?
Yeah.